Hello guys, Adam here. So today we'll be watching CC1101 packet radio based on ATMEL Arduino Uno chip, which is ATMEGA328, I believe. And I'm gonna show you how to build a simple, very simple packet radio which will operate on unlicensed band and will base on the Texas Instrument chip CC1101. So there's a publicly available library called PANSTAMP, which you can use to easy program this chip. And I will be using a slightly modified version by Panagiotis Karagiannis. So the guy from Greece, he done a very great work to, I would say, to simplify the code, to get rid of this Arduino framework from the code. And this is basically a base for my program. So The packet radio is a I would say device which enable you to communicate via half duplex from one terminal, from one PC to another PC, or from one PC to the smartphone. So that will depend all on your creativity. So just for the purpose of this presentation, I will be using PuTTY and two laptops. So first laptop, the old one with the Windows XP, and second one with the CentOS. So this is a different operating system. I already connected one of my devices here. So maybe short introduction what we have to what we have here. So there's a USB to serial port converter, which is basically used to install virtual communication port, serial port in the operating system, and then it will via 3.3 volt logic communicate with the ATMEGA 328 chip, which is basically doing provisioning the CC1101 chip operating on 433 megahertz, but it can be any of the supported bands of this chip. So this band can this chip can operate on the bands like 333 megahertz up to 1 gigahertz. So it's very flexible. It can have its own, I would say, address assigned, so you can communicate with many of those devices, like, I don't know, more than 100. It can support up to four modulation techniques. So I will be using GFSK, and basically it is intended to do a low power communication. So the maximum transceiver power is only 10 milliwatts, so 10 dBm. So to do this presentation, I will be using only 1 milliwatt, because if the power would be higher, then there would be some problems on the short range, because that would cause some disruptions in the signal. So only 1 milliwatt here. But in theory, this chip, when having configured 10 milliwatts, it can the range can be up to maybe several kilometers in open space. So you will probably have to check this. Yes. Okay, so serial converter, this one is sending data from PC to the chip, to the ATMEGA Arduino Uno, and this chip will send this data further to the CC1101, and this guy will receive and transmit data to the radio, to the other device, which is basically the same as here. So the other device is connected here to the Windows XP based laptop, and I will be using PuTTY to show you. Oh, don't die, you guy. Okay, so let's run the PuTTY here. I've already prepared some initial config, so you have to put correct information, like the virtual port number, the proper one, which is bound to the FTDI chip. Okay, this is my first window. So this guy is connected here over USB port. So I've programmed this code to blink the diode to LED when there's something received or transmitted over the radio. And I'm doing the same, so I'm connecting the FTDI chip to the PC, to the Linux-based PC. Hold on, it's not so simple. Okay, so when starting up, it will blink several times, and then it is ready to transmit or receive. Okay, so let's make the same here. So I will run the putty. I already provisioned some settings. So this is a virtual serial port, so you have USB 0 here. And the speed is 9600, so the most commonly used for the terminals, like, I don't know, Cisco routers. Okay, we have the window, so let's move it somewhere here. Let's see. Just to show you that it is working, I will move this one here, and it will be, I don't know if it's even possible to show two screens at the same time, so maybe I will put something here. So like, I don't know, hello world? Hello world. As we can see, it is received here. So now you will see, I will be putting somewhere something on the second screen, like how are you? And this guy will answer, I am fine, thanks. As you can see, it was received on the second screen. So this is a bidirectional communication of a 433 frequency using CC1101 chip. And you have to remember that it is only half duplex. So when there's a one person sending something, like hello, the other one have to wait. Hi. As you can see, it allows both-way communication, so it is unlicensed band. So if your mobile network goes down, you can always utilize this stuff, this device, to communicate with your friends or do some other things. Like I said, it is not encrypted, but you have to do it yourself. You can encrypt this data within the code, so it's up to you to do this. And what else I can say? So I've made some range tests, and it works up to 100 meters with 99% of correct packets. But maybe if you have open space, maybe the range will be higher. So like I said, this chip, this 1101, it is intended to provide low power unlicensed band communications for some IoT stuff, but it can be used for other purposes, like I'm showing here in the packet radio. So it is very, very flexible. You can select the frequency. The frequency can be divided into some kind of channels, subcarriers. And you can assign an address to the device, so the channels will be separated, the devices will have a separated addresses, so you can communicate with a particular one. And I think the most important thing is that this board, it cost only $2, $2, okay? So you can build a simple device, radio device, with very, very low cost. And I will recommend this to everyone, because this chip is very, very powerful. So basically this part is cheaper than my converter, my serial converter based on FTDI chip. Okay, so bye, see you next time. If you have some ideas what to show, please write down something in the remarks. I will probably read all of those. As you can see, the packets, they came from one PC to the another. Bye.